15-minute improv show for you today. Since my book came out today for our suggestion, asked for what your favorite book of all time is, and our suggestion comes to us from our good friend Jen, whose favorite book is Beloved by Toni Morrison. So, interesting choice, but you know. It's her favorite, so that's what we're doing. All right, so without further ado, there's always too much ado. Beloved.
I know you want to learn how to read, but you got to get your slur up first. You gotta learn how to speak like me before I can teach you how to read. You sound drunk, beloved. One more time. Oh, so you're deaf now? Did this just happen? You lost your tongue. You lost your tongue? Do I have your tongue? Did someone give me your... You have your eyes on the prize. Long prize.
Doreen, no. I know you just started working with Beloved. I just want to give you some history of his issues.
Yes, please. Yes. No one gave me a file.
Of course.
Thank you.
Sorry about that. Here is his file. Beloved was attacked by an alligator when he was 3 years old and got his tongue pulled out. So he cannot speak. Yes.
Got it.
So he cannot make any sounds.
That makes sense.
But he's very expressive.
You have a very serious medical condition. Now, I know, Julie, that I've been your doctor for several months now, and I keep...
Yes, Anthony!
I keep coming up with the wrong diagnosis.
Dr. Anthony, you're driving me crazy!
But I believe I have cracked it.
What is it now?
You have a rare condition where you emit an aura that makes it so that you can never be loved by anyone. Animals will not show you affection.
No one.
Your parents gave you up for adoption, even though they were quite wealthy.
Oh my God, what's that smell?
It manifests as an odor that is unpleasant to those with an open heart.
I'm doomed to be lonely for the rest of my life.
Unless you become very wealthy, in which case you can pay people to pretend to like you. That's what Donald Trump does.
So, I'm out of money now. You gave me $1,000, and that was cool. That was for about 2 hours. So it's been 2 hours and 2 minutes. I'm giving another $1,000 to pretend to like you again. So.
Okay, but now it's time for our together time.
No, it's time for you to get out of your checkbook and give me
some physical warmth, Betty.
What do you mean? No one's at my funeral. You're my funeral director. You were supposed to have this whole thing set up, but you really dropped the ball.
Yeah, I was very clear, though, that the interdimensional communication should only be used for emergencies.
Well, this is an emergency. No one's here. No one likes me. Did you even invite them? I'm not there. I don't know.
I admit, when I went through your list of friends, there were some issues. Your best friend, Clive?
Oh, Clive. Me and him are just like that.
Yeah.
Like,
he said...
Lengths of chain.
Thank
together.
God that Mother is dead. He owes me money. You know where I can collect. So, of course, I have to settle your debts out of the $10,000 that you left for me to pay for your funeral.
Why would you do that? That's why I had life insurance.
Well, he explained it.
Why, Jeremy, it is too much for a queen to be so loved by all.
Yes.
I cannot deal with all the attention no longer, Jeremy.
Yes, yes.
So I need you to stop googly-eyeing me, okay? I know.
I
know, it's hard.
But it's how I live my life.
Oh.
You are my life. You are my soul. You are my... my son.
As for everyone in
without
this
the sun, there's darkness. You know that, right?
Yes.
Without the sun, there's darkness.
Yes.
God damn it, Jeremy! You're the king of the world!
I know!
You spend all your time googly eyes at your wife!
I know, but she's so hot!
She's a very attractive woman!
You know she...
But look, as your prime minister... Yes. She is objectively attractive.
Exactly.
The fact that her and I used to be an item before has nothing to do with this conversation.
What do you mean? Used to be an item.
Used to be an item. I believe it's clear.
What is the problem, my love? You know that I slept with many of the knights of the round table.
But I am the king of the knights. You're undermining me. You slept with all the knights.
I also slept with you.
What do you mean? I'm objectively attractive.
Just saying that, like, if there was, you know, some being in the universe devoid of bias, even he, she, it would see you and go, God damn, look at that booty!
But why would you add the word objectively there?
Well, that
why
wouldn't
you just say that I'm attractive?
Well, because
regardless,
I think that I am interested in that booty, because as your teacher, that would be fully inappropriate in this driver's ed class.
But it's
even if it's for adults.
What I'm saying is it's inappropriate for you to say my booty is objectively attractive. You just shouldn't be saying anything about my attractiveness, let alone objectively attractive. Do you know how much that fucks with the person's brain?
I'm just going to have to fail you, and you're going to have to take driver's ed again, and if I happen to be the one teaching it and spend more time in that booty, I guess we can continue.
Hashtag me too.
Okay. So, in driver's ed, you got to make sure you check out the kids. I know it sounds weird.
Check out the kids.
Yes, as in objectively.
Okay, I mean, I've mainly been teaching adult driver's ed,
yes.
And I don't feel weird checking them out.
But that's the thing.
The kids
we're going to kids. Well,
okay.
You know that.
Teenagers.
Teenagers. Thank you. Thank
past
you.
Puberty.
This is why you're my rock.
I'm
you understand
your
what I'm trying to say.
Solid.
Thank you.
This is why you're my hammer.
Board meeting?
Oh, yes.
All of our DMV... conductor teachers?
Yes.
So the numbers look promising, guys. We're getting mostly 70% attractive people passing.
Oh,
remember,
right.
At the DMV of Pasadena, only highly attractive people could get their driver's license, okay? This is part of our record-breaking situation.
Uggos can't drive, though.
Uggos can't drive. That's right.
Well, I was about to say it's a working slogan, but
he's all in.
And of course, if any of the students have any questions, just tell them what's going on. If they're just not attractive enough to pass,
objectively,
of course, you just let them know, okay?
Wouldn't it be better if we didn't tell them that we were judging them by their looks, like most major employers?
No.
Why no?
I don't think you understand.
We keep
we're not judging them. That would be subjectively assessing
their attractiveness.
Oh. Don't be wrong. We are objectively deciding if they're attractive enough to use a car. Mm-hmm. It's very scientific.
Yeah.
I mean, there's certainly no bias at all.
Well, I'm not fully won over, but I do like judging people based on their looks, so hey, let's do it.
Get back to it!
I'm gonna...
Queen? I've had a talk with your husband.
So I heard!
And he'll be off kinging.
There you are with your googly eyes again.
For quite some time.
Mm-hmm.
Googly eyes.
Yes.
There's no love in these eyes. Just pure,
Googliness.
Adulterated lust.
Okay, whatever it is, I am tired of everyone being so highly attracted to me. I just want to be my own person. Maybe I become asexual. Is that so bad?
Oh, you're the queen.
Yes.
You exist to channel our sexual energies at, even if you are unreachable. So asexual would be fine for the public eye. You and I, you know, before King Jeremy came along, we had, moments.
Cut to moments.
Oh.
This magic man.
Oh, my.
You are looking in my eyes.
I'm so glad.
And I shiver.
And this is appropriate.
For almost
I've been waiting for this moment. Tony.
This night. chicks.
Queen?
Ruin.
Yes?
I just feel like we're meant to be together and we'll be together forever. Together.
Cut back.
I really thought we were going to be together forever.
That was before.
Yes.
Before I slept with every man on the round table, including my husband. And now I'm tired. I'm tired of sex. I'm tired of being here just for your all googly eye, your sexual pleasures. I'm more than
that. I have
that.
Your scepter.
Hey.
Hi.
I'm happy you're more than sex. That's why I like to welcome you to sexless marriage.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh, I
yes.
didn't know the kingdom had
yes.
a sexless marriage
yes,
church.
Yes, we do. That's what we do.
What's your name?
My name is Jacob.
Oh,
yes.
Jacob.
We're going to play some Uno, you know?
Yes.
Talk about our people.
Oh, my goodness.
Find ourselves.
Oh.
And then we're going to sleep in separate beds.
Oh, my God.
Hello. I would like to speak with the supervisor, please. I had just failed my driver's test for being objectively attractive.
John Bon Johnson, supervisor extraordinaire. How can I direct this inquiry?
Well, I'm extremely upset.
I can see that.
I failed my driver's test due to my level of attractiveness.
Your tight, wrinkled cheeks are getting all red.
That's
another upset one.
Well, of course I'm upset. I didn't have this problem in Washington State. You Californians think you can judge people based on their looks like in the television shows?
I know, again, let me open up your file. We are not judging you. This is simply, we have some metrics that assess your objective level of attractiveness. The fact that I find you attractive has no bearing on your passing this course. I do see your driving skills were marked as excellent, your knowledge of the rules of the road were excellent, but your tuchus was subpar.
That's a medical issue.
That can be fixed.
Honey, don't be mad you didn't, sorry. You didn't pass your test, darling. That happens. It happened to me a couple times. I had to get plastic surgery twice before passing mine.
Cut to plastic surgery.
Surgery. Now you look like some sort of cut-up alien.
Yes, but I can drive. What's more important, honey? To look real or to be able to move yourself around at your own will? It's either plastic surgery or not being free.
I come from the solar system Maronagon. Ooh, one of ours!
Yeah.
You're so pretty. You must be the best.
Experimental treatment that may allow you to be loved.
You know what, Anthony?
No!
I
you
don't
just broke it all!
Want it.
Well, I hope you're very
this
firm about the sin.
I may not be loved.
You're not loved.
No.
There's no question. There's no uncertainty about
what?
It.
What? That doesn't mean I'm not free. Since I'm not loved, I'm free to do what I please. No one gets mad. Anything. Even the policemen, they find me stinky.
Yes.
So I can get away with anything.
So I heard you didn't pass your test either.
No. I didn't. My tushy's not good enough.
Well, my chest is too big.
Huh.
Wait, I have an idea. What if I gave you some of my chest to your tush?
Oh my god. I was thinking the exact same thing even before you said that.
Really?
That's what was going through my mind.
Did someone call for a plastic surgeon?
I did.
Oh, honey, I'm so glad you decided to go ahead with the surgery.
Wow, this new medical technology.
I am Dr. God!
Wow, the beloved Dr. God, huh?
It's so cool. I wear weird-shaped shirts now.
And I bet that now you feel beloved.
I do. Beloved.
Buy one surgery and get two free. That's our show.
Yeah, my book came out today. It's called Love from Amanda to Zoe. It's available on Amazon. There's a link with this video. There's not, unfortunately. I guess I should have put some of that in there. There is plenty of sex. There's plenty of drugs. There's plenty of love. There's plenty of words. It's only like 200 pages. It's a quick read. You breeze right through it. You can check out the first two chapters on ianmark.ptnt.com.